But they got the goal in the first half from Peter Lovenkrantz. Great ball from Donald Boer.
Yeah, it has to be considered a first-class goal with this terrific ball from De Boer there. He opened up the game. Kamara will feel a little bit disappointed with their marking and just the level of cover, because Lovenkrantz picks the ball up in a wide area and gets running right on and goal. Fires in a good shot, and the power and pace has beaten Gordon Marshall in the near post. I thought he went going to cross goal with the shot. I'm sure Gordon Marshall was half anticipating that.
They brought Craig Dargo on at half time, and we said that Kamara have to go at Rangers, and they certainly did. He almost made an impact straight away.
Yeah, exactly. I thought the second half they did much better. We had one or two opportunities. As you say, they changed things around, and certainly the second half I thought was much better. You know, they gave it their best shot. They tried to put the pressure, you know, on top of Rangers, and they had one or two little opportunities where they might have just got a goal.
This was a fairly audacious effort, but it almost worked for him, Gary McSwiggan.
Yeah, I mean, I thought, well, he's dreaming there. I don't think he expected him to shoot, but it was a cracking effort, and it was unfortunate just to, you know, hit the wood button and come out.
Yeah, now Rangers had an awful lot of opportunities, Gordon, and it should have been an awful lot more than 1-0.
Absolutely, that's the thing. Kamara were a lot better in the second half. It was a good second half, a better performance from them, but the Rangers, they're just an inability to take chances has made this a tight scoreline. Uh-huh. If you take the chances that Rangers had and look at it, they could easily have three clear-cut openings in the second half. They've got other efforts as well, but clear-cut chance. This was a good bit of play, and uh-huh, maybe a bit unlucky, but not the same as the ones they were actually missing. Ronald De Boer is very good in there, missed a couple of clear-cut headers. Michael Mould once again missed a near post shot, but as I say, it was a better second half, but definitely Rangers are not finishing games off when they should be, and people are calling for a striker, and you know, the fans might be right in that respect. They need, yeah, somebody who's an out-and-out goal scorer.
Well, this is very disappointing. I mean, he did everything right, and he tries the outside of the foot, and of course it goes by the post. And not only Caniggia missed, but if Stefan Kloss, as we're going to see in a minute, we said in the first half he flapped at a couple of things, and he did it again there.
Yeah, he certainly looked a bit ropey in cross balls. First half he flapped at one, and there were two or three different instances there where he should have maybe came and caught, which he didn't.
Yeah, well, we talked about Ronald De Boer being good in the air.
He is good in the air. Yeah. He's very good in the air. He's a good header of the ball, and I'm sure he can't believe that himself, because he missed two clear-cut chances. That's a better header.
Yeah.
Give him credit for that one, but the first one is a real bad miss, and it could have eased the pressure on Rangers. Michael Moles once again, the same he did in the Partick Thistle game. He's gone for that near post when you think that really a player of his quality should be going to cross.